There are two things in this life that you cannot avoid, and those are death and taxes. The big difference is that death cannot be postponed, but taxes can. So you can postpone them, you can push them off as much as you want, even for your entire lifetime. And I will show you how in this video. Hi there, I'm Jaime Shekaiben. Welcome to The Foreigner in America. And today is a very interesting topic about taxation and all the lies that the financial gurus are telling you. So I'm gonna show you what the truth is and how much you will pay in your taxes. If you haven't read a book from Mr. Robert Kiyosaki called The Cashflow Quadrant, please do. It's his best book in my taste, it's his second book. And I will make reference of The Cashflow Quadrant for this video. So I don't want you coming up and saying,
Jaime, you just copycat, you just are using other people's information. You didn't do that quadrant.
So I will use the Cashflow Quadrant from Mr. Robert Kiyosaki. Make sure you read that book. I've heard multiple videos and multiple different kind of people saying that you pay a lot in taxes. I've heard people complaining.
Oh my God, I pay so much in taxes. I wish I paid less taxes.
Wait a minute. The more taxes you pay, it means two things. One, the more money you make. And two, that you are making your money in the wrong side of the quadrants. You are cheering for the wrong team. So to start off this video, let me explain to you what this quadrant is. This is the four kinds or the four ways to make money. Either you make money as an employee, as a self-employed, as a business owner, or as an investor. And I'm gonna go through each one of them and tell you how they're taxed and how you can protect your money from taxes. So let's start with the top left corner, which is the employee. This is the most common in America. It's 60% of all workers are employed. It's not a bad thing. It's not the worst, but it's the worst for taxes. And you have the least amount of control over your taxes. Let me explain you why. The lie that financial gurus say to employees is,
you're gonna pay 40% in taxes.
So people are like,
oh my God, 40% of my money. 40 cents out of every dollar I'm gonna pay in taxes. Why? It's too much.
That is a complete lie. The IRS, how it works, it collects taxes from each one of the quadrants. And believe it or not, 80% of all the taxes collected in the country go for the right side of the quadrant with business owners and investors because of the amounts they handle. So all the money that you make in a W-2 as a salary, or bonus or compensation is treated as earned income. And earned income is the worst with taxes because you have to go through the federal tax brackets. And depending on your income, it goes from 0 to 37%. You cannot control that. It just goes directly into employees' salaries. And depending on how you file, there are four categories: single filers, married filing jointly, married filing separately, and head of household. So three things matter here: how much you make, how you file, and where you live, in which state. Because there are nine states, remember, nine states that do not have state income taxes, including Texas, which I live in Texas, so it's a great state to be. After paying your federal income tax, you have to pay something called FICA. F-I-C-A, Federal Insurance Contributions Act. This is a way for the government to fund Social Security and Medicare for Americans and residents. That money is for retirees, for children of deceased workers, and for persons with disabilities. FICA is 7.65% of your taxes. 6.2 goes for Social Security and 1.45% goes for Medicare. Let me give you an example. If you're single living in Texas, and you're making $50,000 a year, you will be paying around $4,342 in taxes. And you're going to be situated in the 12% bracket after you get your $12,400 standard deduction. And then FICA, as I told you, is 7.65%, which is $3,825. So that makes a grand total of $8,167. That's 16.3%. So where did the 40% come from? Are they assuming that everyone is a millionaire here or what? Let me give you two more examples of earned income and how much people pay in taxes. If you make $100,000 in Texas as a single person, you will pay a total of 22.9% in taxes. If you make $500,000 a year, which is a substantial amount of money, single in Texas, you will pay 32.9%. The only reason why you would go to the 40%+ is if you live in a state like California, where they have a hefty state income tax. People in California, single, they have to make more than $375,000 to get taxed 40% of their income. And that can go all the way to 52%, 54% if you go to the millions. But I mean, it's expensive to live in the beach. So now that you know that 40% is a big lie, and that you have to be making $375 or more if you're in California, or millions if you're in one of the 9 states that don't pay state income tax, I want to tell you why employees have no control over their taxes. And that's the worst quadrant to be at. The IRS, the Internal Revenue Service, taxes employers, not employees. That means that whatever money you receive as an employee is going to be post-taxes. They don't trust you with your taxes. That's pretty much it. They don't give you the money pre-tax, so you get your money, you separate the tax, and then you pay it back. They don't trust an employee doing that. That's why the employer has to do it, and the employer has to give the IRS the money from taxes. And that and those commercials coming up from HR Block and all those guys saying,
claim your billions, America.
That's just an incentive for employees to present and validate the information for their taxes. And then if you got withheld more money than what you had to, you get a return. Otherwise, you have to pay some money back. But the majority of the taxes are already handled by your employer. So being an employee is a worst quadrant for the taxes, and you have no control. What else can you do? Well, you can go to a different quadrant. Let's go now to the lower left quadrant, which is the self-employed. This is where it starts getting funky and interesting. According to the financial gurus, these guys, the self-employed, pay 60% tax. That's outrageous. How did they come up with this number? Is that true? When you're self-employed, you're actually not considered an employee. So I don't like the term self-employed. I prefer to call it freelancer, because you're free actually with your time. You can do whatever you want. A freelancer makes money from whatever activity you name it. A real estate agent, a dentist, a doctor, a lawyer, buying and selling, consulting, teaching, everything, any activity that is not in a W-2 that makes money is considered freelance money. But you know, for the IRS, it's also considered earned income. It's the same income that if you were an employee. So freelancers or self-employed pay the same amount of federal income tax than employees. It's the same. Same brackets, same categories. Everything is the same. The difference is the FICA. The FICA is double. 7.65 for employees and 15.3 for self-employed. And why is this? Because your company that hires you pays the other half of the FICA. That's why employees pay only half, self-employed have to pay double. So this means that 60% is a big fat lie. Whatever you pay as an employee, you will just pay 7.65% more if you're self-employed. But the difference comes in the deductions. So let me give you a fun fact about Social Security and Medicare, so you impress your friends. Social Security is capped at $137,700. So once you pay 6.2% of $137,700, which is $8,537.4, that's all you're gonna pay in Social Security for the year. So if you make more than $137,700, the moment you hit that, you're gonna get a 6.2% raise for the rest of the year. Medicare works the other way. Medicare is 1.45% uncapped. Doesn't matter if you make 50, 100, 500, a million. You will always pay 1.45. But once you hit 200,000 for a single or 250 for married, you're gonna pay an extra 0.9% on the excess over that amount. So let's say you make 220, single. Well, you're gonna pay only Social Security tax all the way to 137.7, but you're gonna pay 1.45% on 220 plus 0.9% on the 20,000 in excess. You get it, right? When you're an employee, you're very limited on what you can deduct, the protections you have for taxes. And I'll explain to you at the end how you can protect your money on each of the quadrants, so stay tuned. But when you're self-employed, let's say a realtor, you can deduct a lot of things. Your miles, your phone, your subscriptions, anything you pay with customers, meals. There's a lot of deductions and you take those away from your income so you get less money taxed. So at the end, freelancers are gonna pay less taxes than employees, not more. It's not 40% and 60%. Actually, employees have very little to deduct and very little control, but freelancers, you can deduct as much money as you want. And at the end, that's 7.65% more than you're paying on self-employment. You can deduct that and even more. And you know what? Self-employed people historically make a lot more money than employees because they're not capped with a salary. The more you work, the more customers you serve, the more value you bring, the more you make. You're not capped by a salary like employees. And now let's go to the right side of the quadrants, the top right corner, which is the business owners. This is where it gets good. Business owners have a lot of control over their taxes. What do financial gurus say about business owners? They pay 20% tax, all of them. Let's find out. So a business owner will more likely create an entity, either an LLC, an S-Corp, or a C-Corp. Those are the most common ones that I've seen. If you operate under an LLC or an S-Corp, all the earnings are gonna fall through your personal income. What does this mean? Well, if you make $100,000 in your S-Corp, those are gonna fall into the federal tax brackets, exactly the same as if you were self-employed. And if you own a C-Corporation, then that one files a tax return on its own. So it's taxed under the 21% tax code. There's a lot of things to consider. If you're actually thinking of creating an LLC, an S Corp, or a C Corp, make sure you find professional advice from either a lawyer or a CPA that knows about taxes before you actually do something with this. There are many ways you can save money with a business. Business expenses are tax deductible. Salaries are tax deductible if you hire people and get leverage. Charitable donations are tax deductible. Even if you buy a car, if you get a car lease under the company and you use it, guess what? It's tax deductible. The amount of control you have operating a business is unlimited. So the 20% that the gurus are saying, it's actually not true. Businesses can pay from zero or very close to zero if they have a lot of deductions, or they can go all the way to pay more than 40 or 45% if they are S corporations or LLCs and it all falls through a personal income with no deductions. Like you have a business that has no deductions, no expenses, just make a lot of money, you're gonna be charged a lot of tax if you cannot make it work through a C corporation or any kind of legal way. So what is the last and best part of making money and protecting your taxes? The lower right corner, the lower right quadrant, which is the investor. This is the best quadrant to be at. Even the gurus say that, which I agree. Being an investor is the best way you can make money and protect your money from taxation. They say that investors pay no money in tax, zero. That is a big fat lie. The two best long-term investments that I always recommend in my channel are a portfolio of stocks and bonds in the markets and rental real estate. And you know what? They both pay taxes. If you hold an investment less than 1 year, it's a non-qualified investment. If you sell it, like a stock, that will count under your personal income and go through the tax brackets. If you hold it more than 1 year, it becomes qualified, and then it's taxed either 0, 15, or 20%, depending on your income level. The same for real estate. All the rents come as ordinary income. The good thing here is that you can depreciate rents. You have a property, you rent it, you pay your mortgage, escrow, property management, you pay everything, you get cash flow. But then you depreciate the property in 27 and a half years if it's residential, or 39 if it's commercial. And then most all of it is free from taxation. That's why I love real estate. Now, this is a good part of the video. Imagine that you made $1 million on each of the quadrants. How do you get taxed and how do you protect your money? So for example, an employee, a C-suite executive, making $1 million in cash as personal income in Texas, he will be charged 36.04% in taxes. That's $360,400. No control over it. If that same person is in California, you add a 10.72% over it, making 46.76% in taxes. What's the only way employees can protect their money from taxation? 401k, IRA, and HSA. There are other vehicles, but those are the most common. 2020, you can put $19,500 in a 401k as an employee, and you can get a company match, which I will recommend you always get. You can put $6,000 in an IRA, and you can put $3,550 in an HSA. HSAs are only if you have a high deductible medical plan at work. If you have PPO or something better, you're not eligible. That's all you can protect. Once you protect those probably 25 to 30 grand, all the million is gonna get taxed by the IRS at 36 to 47%. In the S quadrant, it's even worse. For example, a doctor, a surgeon making $1 million a year, in Texas, he will be charged 38.9% in taxes. In California, well, you add 10.72%. So you're almost looking at 50% in taxes. How can a doctor reduce their taxation? Deductions, deductions, deductions. But it's very hard to deduct money from $1 million. The more you can deduct, probably is at 10%. If that person has a lot of expenses, but the taxes are gonna go and straight take their money. A business owner making $1 million in earnings would have a lot of opportunity to deduct things. As I told you, having salaries, paying business expenses, getting pre-tax accounts. There's a lot of pre-tax accounts for business owners that you don't know about, that employees don't know about, and you can protect even $500, $600, $1 million a year in taxes. You can put them away and the IRS will not grab that money. So accordingly, I will say a business will pay around 10 to 15% of that $1 million in taxes. And an investor, it varies widely. I mean, what are you investing at? If you play with timing, if you don't sell before a year, if you do a lot of real estate, or if you do a lot of stocks and bonds, you will look at around 15 to 20% in taxes. But zero, it's very hard to get zero. Let me give you one example where you get 0%. If you sell a property and then buy another property using a 1032 exchange, then you will defer all taxation and pay zero in taxes. So there are specific examples where you pay zero, but not all investors pay zero taxes. So which quadrant are you making your money at? Which one do you think it will make you rich the fastest? Comment below, let me know. Now let me give you the further insight for this video. It's gonna be short, but really interesting. When you come to this country as a foreigner like myself, you need a source of income. And you can come family-sponsored, employment-sponsored, by asylum, a lot of different ways. If you're not a U.S. permanent resident, you're still paying FICA. You're still paying either 7.65 or 15.3, depending on whether you're an employee or you're a freelancer. So you're funding those programs and you're not getting any benefit whatsoever. It's very important that you keep up with your taxes when you're a foreigner in this country, so your immigration process goes smooth and you don't have any more obstacles than the ones you are currently having. As soon as you get to this country, explore investment options. If you're family sponsored or if you're not an investor visa, then you can pursue side incomes. If you're employment sponsored, make sure you're very careful with side incomes because they're not allowed. But you can do rental real estate. You can do Wall Street investments without any concern from the IRS. Do not feel left behind. Pay your taxes and be part of this great community. If you liked my video, give me a like. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't lose any one of my Monday videos. And share with your friends. I mean, get the community going. Leave your comments, check out my past videos, let me know what you think, and until next time.